The XDC was really, really a very robust network even at that point of time. And the fees, since we were a DePIN project, it was required that we pay in a huge amount of fees to all our node operators. We have around 3,000 node operators. So we need to pay them for the nodes every month.
Hello, everyone, and welcome again to another episode of the XDC MENA Podcast, where we talk about blockchain, technology, projects, innovation, and of course, about the XDC network. Joining us today is none other than Murphy John, who works and represents StorX. StorX is the first DePIN project at XDC Network. So let's talk and deep dive about decentralized physical infrastructure networks. So Murphy, welcome to the podcast. And if you can tell us about yourself and tell us what is StorX.
Hey, Rebecca, thank you very much for hanging here. It's really excited to be a part of XDC podcast. So yeah, my name is Murphy John and I represent StorX Network. We are one of the first DePIN projects that's built on XDC. About my background, I have been involved with the internet infrastructure industry for more than 25 years now. Started all over in 1998 when internet just started in a very nascent stage. We were a part of an organization which was setting up internet infrastructure, providing services like email, secure services, access services. And that's how my journey started with managing data, accessing data, providing services to the corporate entities.
I see. So long way back from 1998, from the inception of internet. So I think that, installation in this infrastructure of internet, that influenced you to the DePIN when it comes to Web3. So yeah, how does StorX differ from traditional services? And if you can explain the key principles of storage.
We try to change the whole way in which the data is being sent across or secured by any system. How we do is we use XDC blockchain, obviously, to provide this kind of setup. So whenever somebody is using StorX to store their data, securely store their data, what we do is in the source itself, we encrypt the data with user's unique passphrase. That means the data is encrypted at user's source itself, and then the encrypted data is transferred to the StorX platform, where it's again fragmented into small pieces. These fragments are then replicated into multiple replication copies, and then we ensure that this is distributed all over to the network of around 3,000 nodes which are spread worldwide. So because of the unique way in which we are processing the data, it ensures that the data is really very private, very secure, geographically redundant across multiple locations. At the same time, it ensures that nobody can really snoop in or censor your data in any possible way.
So you're telling me that this data storage or the data that I put in storage, it's very secure?
That's right. It's very secure. It's very private. And it cannot be accessed by anyone, including the StorX as a platform.
All right. So it's very secure because not only the data is encrypted, it's fragmented and distributed to 3,000 node operators.
It's fragmented, replicated, and distributed. There are three phases of data being processed before it's finally stored in a specific location.
All right. Perfect. And I know that you have prepared a comprehensive video demonstration of how StorX works. So let's play that out.
Welcome to StorX. Today, we'll take you through a quick demo of StorX, the decentralized cloud storage DePIN project built on XDC. To get started, go to storx.tech and log in using your credentials. Once logged in, you'll land on the StorX dashboard, your hub for managing your account. On the left-hand side, you'll find several options. The dashboard gives an overview of your account. The vaults act as a secured folder to store your data on StorX network. Each vault has its own passphrase, which ensure total privacy and security of each vault. Users can create unlimited number of vaults and set passphrase for each. Under resources, you'll find user guidelines, blogs with the latest updates, and help to reach out to support. The dashboard also tracks your bandwidth and storage usage. If you need more space, you can upgrade your plan. StorX offers options for both individuals, ranging from 20 gigabytes to 100 gigabytes in enterprises, from 500 gigabytes to 10 terabytes. Select a plan, complete the payment process, and you're ready to go. Creating a vault is simple. Just click Create Vault, enter a unique name, avoid capital letters, and set a passphrase. Once created, you can upload files directly or organize them into folders. Files and vaults come with options to download, share, publish, or delete. You'll also see blocks for vaults, access grants, and billing. Access grants let you securely share files. Create a grant by selecting permissions like write, list, and delete. Choose a vault, set an expiration date, set passphrase, and generate the necessary keys. In the top right corner, the user icon gives you access to billing, access grant, account settings, and the option to log out. From updating your details to managing access, everything is streamlined for ease of use. StorX not only securely stores your data, but also empowers you to host a node and earn rewards. To become a node host, visit farmer.storx.io, where you'll find everything you need to get started. Explore the node guidelines to understand the requirements, follow step-by-step instructions, and learn all about becoming a node operator. By hosting a node, you're contributing to the StorX ecosystem while earning rewards for your efforts. StorX isn't just a cloud storage solution. It's a community-driven platform offering unparalleled data security and exciting earning opportunities. Start your journey with StorX today and become a part of the decentralized future.
So yeah, that is a wonderful comprehensive demonstration. You know, the UI is very, it's very clean to the eye and it's very seamless. So yeah, wonderful demonstration that you have.
Thank you very much.
And Murphy, I know that you mentioned already that StorX is a DePIN project that is built in XDC Network and it's recognized as the first one. So I'm curious to know why XDC Network out of all the other blockchain networks?
That's a very interesting question. So initially, when we started thinking about having some concept like this, it was required that we need a very robust blockchain system that should be we should partner with to ensure that the system works seamlessly very well. During that phase, we started looking into a lot of projects, a lot of ecosystems that were available. We evaluated into different segments in terms of what is the kind of fees that we have, what is the kind of support that we'll get in. How do we work with them long term? And that's where we found XDC was a very unique value. From the day one itself, we had got very good support from the tech team. We have very good backing from the founders. We feel like it's home. We can come and approach them at any point of time. Other than that, the XDC was really, really a very robust network, even at that point of time. And the fees, since we were a DePIN project, it was required that we pay in a huge amount of fees to all our node operators. We have around 3,000 node operators. So we need to pay them for the nodes every month. So, and we need to ensure that this all these node operators get maximum value. So that's how we shortlisted XDC system, because it was one of the best at that point of time. It was one of the lowest gas fees. It's like nearly zero, and our node operators are really very happy that they get to ensure the full value that we pay to them. So it's really that kind of partnership that we have for the past 3 or 4 years, and we're still very happy and our partnership's still going very strong.
Okay, perfect. Well, XDC obviously is a wise choice. And yeah, you started reviewing XDC 4 to 5 years back, and you already realized that XDC has a nearly zero gas fees. And imagine that now that XDC network upgraded to XDC 2.0. So yeah, Murphy, DePIN is getting a lot of traction this year, right? So how do you think StorX is shaping or trying to contribute to the evolution of DePIN?
So as any growth phase, you'll find a lot of projects which are there now in DePIN. Half of them I know are useless. Many of them will just fail in because they just want to be a bandwagon of something that's rising. So when we conceptualized this project, that's 4 years back, we knew that there is a requirement for very secure storage. There's a requirement where the data needs to be secure and people need to ensure that nobody can access their data. This is a major problem that you see with all the traditional service providers. You're already aware of the hacking. You're already aware of the data mismanagement. So that's how we designed the whole system, that it should be very, very secure. It should, people should not worry if they are storing the data and somebody is accessing it, somebody is trying to monetize it, or somebody is trying to weaponize it against you. So that's the whole idea that we wanted to. And hence the technology is built in such a way that it provides a seamless integration. Plus, we have a lot of integration with third-party tools. We have a lot of upcoming integrations, which we're very excited to announce in the new future. And it would be a really wonderful journey to be a part of it.
Yeah, perfect. So yes, it's all about security and adding the decentralized architecture to it. And yes, you mentioned future partnerships, but can you tell us more about, you know, centralized exchange listings or any imminent events that you guys will be participating to, or the general roadmap of StorX?
We'll be coming up with a few exchanges. We're already in talk with a few exchanges. We see them listing in Q1 and Q2 of 2025. We're very slow and we're very choosy in terms of selecting the exchanges and partnering with them. We are coming up with a lot of events. We would be participating in Consensus 2025 in Hong Kong and a couple of other events, Token 2049 in Dubai and Singapore as well. We would be sponsoring developers conferences across the world, majorly in Germany. A lot of customer pilot announcements that we plan to have in Q2. We are already running a lot of pilots with a lot of companies here across the globe. We feel that those would turn into like proper commercial contracts by the mid of next year.
All right. Wonderful roadmap. A lot to watch out for the year 2025. And yes, please check out all these sexes where StorX is already listed, but please do your own research. So yeah, before we end the podcast, Murphy, any final message to our viewers out there?
Very important thing is that the data landmark is changing and people need to change. There's a lot of new innovation that is already here, but I find most of the companies are still stuck with the traditional cloud, the traditional way in data is so people should start adopting in the technology and start building a roadmap where they have decentralized cloud storage built into their roadmap of data security and data storage.
Yeah, I agree with you. Technology builds too fast and it moves too quickly. So all of us must be, you know, properly educated, and we should leverage this kind of technology that we have. So yeah, Murphy, thank you so much for being part of the podcast. And all of the links of StorX, their GitHub repos, the centralized exchanges, all of those will be listed under the description of the video. And if you guys wanted to know more about XDC Network, please visit www.zinfin.org. And if you are a tech enthusiast who has a question about XDC Network, please post your question to www.xdc.dev. So keep exploring, keep learning. Until the next episode.